it was in the 20% when I started. And the things that we can do today to look at the genetics of an embryo, or the genetics of a couple, or the genetics of when the best time to transfer is, none of those things were possible 25 years ago when I started in the field. And so I've spent my career doing reproductive genetics, which is an interesting place to be. It's an intersection of being a really, really heavy scientific topic. Most people are afraid of genetics. They don't want to know from it. Most clinicians are a little bit afraid of it. You know, my wife is an IVF nurse, and she's probably the most educated genetic IVF nurse in the world because she's married to me. We talk about it all day, every day, right? But it's hard sometimes for us, people like me, to translate what I do to Dr. Chen, and for Dr. Chen to then translate it to the patient who in general doesn't know much about genetics, right? And so to circle back, you know, when I started, the chance of getting pregnant was in the 20% to maybe 30%. Today it's in the high 50s, low 60s. And a lot of that is not just genetic testing, but certainly a lot of that comes from genetic testing, right? We can today, as Dr. Chen mentioned, if you do carrier screening through a company like Sema4 and you know you have a genetic disease, we can eliminate that genetic disease in embryos. It's simple on our end. It's kind of futuristic for everybody else, but we can do that, right? We can make that happen. We can screen embryos for common chromosome abnormalities, things like trisomy 16, which causes miscarriages, trisomy 21, Down syndrome. But it turns out an embryo, even a really good-looking embryo, can be wildly genetically abnormal and have zero chance of implanting. So by being able to screen embryos before you put them back in, it allows physicians like Dr. Chen to do single embryo transfer, which is much safer, but still with much higher reliability because of genetic testing. We mentioned a test called ERA, and I don't want to make this a commercial. ERA is a test that looks at endometrial receptivity. The idea being that the majority of patients, the right time to transfer an embryo is the right time to transfer an embryo. But in the subset of patients, it's not the right time. And the patient simply needs more or less progesterone to give her a higher chance of getting pregnant. And we can do a test, look at that, and then give that result back to Dr. Chen and say, this patient's personalized best chance of getting pregnant is actually with 132 hours of progesterone, not 120. So it's really bringing personalized medicine to the IVF industry, which is, for me, it's the bleeding edge of the future of making this not just we're going to get some eggs and make some embryos, but we're going to do the best we can to get the best chance of having the best eggs and the most productive chance of getting pregnant. And that's really what the field of reproductive genetics is all about. And in the end, you know, if you think about unexplained fertility, you can make perfectly lovely embryos that might be aneuploid, and you're not getting pregnant because you're making embryos that have no chance of getting you pregnant. Or you're making great embryos that are chromosomally normal, but you're transferring them at the wrong time, too early, too late, which can also lead to miscarriage. So really, you know, some of the tests that we can do, it's not going to explain unexplained infertility, but it's going to get you around that problem and get you to the point where you have the best chance of getting pregnant.